Hi guys, welcome to
Feed Me Gond.
Today we'll be making Gond ke laddu. Gond is also known as acacia or jagakanth. It is a winter superfood that keeps your body warm. It is also great for lactating moms, helps reduce joint pain, and as shared by celebrity nutritionist Rujuta Devekar, we should also have it when we have any kind of physiological or psychological stress. So let's get started. To a pan, add some ghee. We'll be using a total of 3/4 cup or 150 grams of desi cow ghee for the entire recipe. Add more or less as per your requirement in each stage, but wherever we've mentioned to add more, make sure you do that. Now to this ghee, we will add 50 grams of almonds, 50 grams of cashews, and 50 grams of pistachios. We will saute these dry fruits in ghee until the cashews turn golden. You can use any dry fruits of your choice. Once that is done, remove it from the pan. Now in the same ghee, we will add 1.5 tablespoons of black pepper, 1.5 tablespoons of fenugreek or methi seeds, 2 tablespoons of poppy seeds or khaskhas. Saute this for 1 minute. And then we will add 200 grams of urad dal. Saute everything till the urad dal turns golden. And then remove this in a plate as well. Now we will be frying our gond, so add a good amount of ghee to the pan. It is very important to fry the gond in a good amount of ghee, or else it may cause digestive distress and stick to your teeth. We will be using a total of 150 grams of gond. Don't fry it all together. Add it little by little. Fry it in 3 parts and don't fry everything together. The gond should submerge into the ghee. Flip the gond towards the other side and cook it. It should swell up really well. While that is happening, hit the like button. It is a great way to support us, so please make sure that you hit the like button. Also, if you are new to the channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button, click on the bell icon and select all to never miss any of our unique recipes. Moving back to the recipe, then remove it from the flame. Repeat this process for the rest of the gond. Do not add all the ghee at one time and add ghee also in batches, or else the gond might absorb the entire ghee in one go only. Once we have fried all our gond, if the ghee is still clear and clean, in the same ghee, we will add 200 grams of whole wheat flour or gehu ka aata. We will saute our aata until it turns golden, and then we will remove it from the pan. Now add some ghee to the same pan. We will add 25 grams of desiccated coconut or coconut ka burada to the ghee. We will saute the coconut as well till it turns lightly golden. Once that is done, we will take it off the flame. Once the urad dal and the dry fruits have cooled down, we will blend them and add it to a big bowl. We will also blend our gond. And add that to the same bowl as well. Add the sauteed coconut too. Take a pan, add 1/3 cup of water. To this add 300 grams of jaggery. Try using brownish jaggery instead of golden jaggery because the golden jaggery is even more processed, so avoid using that. Let the jaggery melt completely. And cook it till it reaches string consistency. Once that is done, we will add 1 tablespoon of salt or ginger powder. And mix it well. Now we will add this hot jaggery to the bowl with our other ingredients. And mix it well. Then we will add our sauteed gehu ka aata or whole wheat flour to the bowl as well and mix all of these ingredients together. While it is still hot, we will make laddus because it is easier to make laddus when the mixture is hot. Don't burn yourself, but make sure that it is hot enough for the laddus to come together. Let the laddus sit for some time and then serve it once it cools down a bit. These are extremely nutritious, so you can have them on a daily basis. You can eat half or one depending on your health goals and your current health condition. Do let us know what you think about this recipe.